usual, totally forgot to press record, but here it is. I'm just using a felt tip liner, and I'm just outlining a circle around both eyes. And I'm just using the top of my brows to start out that outline, and I'm just going around and underneath right to where I normally get my dark circles. And I'm just enclosing that circle, and I'm just using this felt tip liner just so I can outline where all the black is going to go. But essentially, I'm just going to do this around my eyes, and then I'm also going to do it around my nose, but you'll see that in just a minute. So now I'm just going to take this cream eyeshadow palette, and I'm going to go in with this black color, and I'm going to be applying this right in my crease area in like an upside down U shape, and I'm leaving the actual lid space bare. I'm going to be applying a red cream shadow in that bare space. So in the meantime, I'm just going to apply the black, and I'm just going to smudge this out. Doesn't matter if it's neat or not. It's all going to get covered in black anyways, but I just want something for my red eyeshadow to stick to. So I'm going to smudge this out, and I'm going to also apply it to my lower lash line because I'll be applying my red eyeshadow here as well. Now I'm just going to go in with that red cream color, and I'm just going to be applying this on that empty lid space. Now I'm just going to go in with MAC's Basic Red Pigment, and this is an amazing red color. So I'm applying this with my 242 flat shader brush, and I'm just going to pack this right on top of that red and just softly blend that up into the black. And then I'm going to go in with a fluffy blending brush and just kind of fade that out into the black. Before I continue on with the fading of the red, I'm just going to go ahead and fill in that circle with a black gel liner. You can use a gel liner, cream liner, it doesn't really matter, as long as it's something that's long wearing. So that way I don't really have to set this with any type of powder eyeshadow. So I'm just applying this with a synthetic brush, and I'm just going to fill in that circle just like so. So now once you have that all filled in, you're going to go ahead and take a fluffy blending brush and start blending up that red. And then you'll kind of see it turn into a really, really dark pink, but that's the type of effect that I'm going for, is just a faded red ring around the eye and then surrounded by black. So now I'm just going in with my felt tip liner, and I'm just making the outline on my nose, and I'm going to do the same things, just outlining it, and then I'll be filling it in with black later. I'm going to move on to my face. I'm going to take my MAC Fix Plus, or you could use water if you're using aqua colors, but this is my Wolf FX Hydro Colors, and I'm just using the white and making sure to really get that saturated in either water or Fix Plus. And I'm just using a flat foundation brush, and I'm applying this all over the perimeter of my face. And I'm just going to be carefully going around the areas with the black just to make sure I don't blend in that white and black to make a gray. So I'm just going to carefully do this, and I'm going to do this until it's a very opaque white all over my face. You don't need to blend this down your neck, it should just be surrounding your face. Now I'm just taking my Ben Nye Neutral Set, and this is just a really transparent white powder, and you can even put this on top of colors like I'll be doing on top of the black, and it doesn't leave any white cast or anything. So love this, and I'm applying it with a powder puff, and I'm going to be brushing away the remaining powder with a large fluffy brush. I'm just filling in my nose with the black Hydra color. You could also use your gel liner if you prefer, but I find that the gel liner is best around the surrounding eye area, and I think my Hydra colors will do better on my nose. Now going back in with that felt liner, I'm just going to draw the petals that will be surrounding the black eyes, and just drawing little tiny upside down U's. They don't have to be exactly the same size, but I prefer them to be, so I'm going to try to keep them as consistent as possible. And I'm just going to do this until my entire eye is surrounded with the petals, and then I'm going to move on to the next eye and do the same thing. My felt tip liner again. I'm just going to draw a line straight down from my forehead, and I'll be drawing a couple different lines on each side, and this is just going to be my little spider web design that I'll be having on my forehead. You can use a ruler or some straight edge if you really want this to be really precise, but I'm just going to freehand it. So once I draw in the lines, I'll be drawing in the U's to make the spiderweb design. I'm just going to take my red Hydra color. You can use like lipstick or a lip liner to fill this part in, or just a red eyeshadow if you have that mixed in with a little bit of water. But I like my Hydra colors, so I'm going to stick with that. And I'm just going to carefully fill in each little petal with the red. Don't worry if it gets on some of the black or overlaps the outline. I'm just going to go around these with black outline again once I've filled them in with red. So no worries about being neat. Really wanted something green on my face just because I didn't want it to be black, red, and white only. So I thought of the idea of just drawing in a little leaf right underneath each eye. So kind of like the petals of a flower, leaf of a flower. So I'm just freehanding this, making sure both sides are the same. And then I'm filling it in with my green Hydra color. And then I'll just be drawing in the lines in between the leaves to make it look like an actual leaf once I've filled it in with green. And then I'm just drawing in the lines with a mixture of green and a little bit of black to darken it up. With the black Hydra color, and I'm just going to take that with a fine tip brush. And I'm just gonna go around all of the designs that I've drawn on my face, and I'm just gonna make sure to define the outline of them just so it looks a little bit neater, especially around the petals. I went ahead and drew a little heart on my chin, and I'm just going to be filling that in with a red and a pink, and I'm going to kind of gradate the red into the pink so that way it kind of gives it a nicer looking color gradient rather than just one solid color. Draw the outline of the smile, And you can freehand this to be a smiling face or a frowning face or a combination of the two. I'm just kind of drawing kind of like a little wave on each side, just making sure that they remain the same and consistent. And then I'll be making sure to draw in the stitches. Try to keep the lines equal on both sides, but I think I actually ended up with one extra line on one of the sides. Okay, now for the lips, I went ahead and outlined it with a black eyeliner, and I'm just going to go in with a red lipstick, and I'm going in with a lip brush, and I'm just going to fill that in. And with the lip brush, I'm just going to blend in the red with that black liner, so that way it kind of gives it a deeper, vampier look. And that is it for the Sugar Skull Day of the Dead tutorial. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!